Hi, it's Daniel.
And Jenny.
And we are at Goofy's Kitchen at the Disneyland Hotel for their Christmas brunch.
One of the best features about these holiday-themed character meals is that the characters are in special costumes. So since this is the holiday brunch, they'll be wearing their holiday costumes.
We're here with our family to celebrate the holiday season. And we do want to point out that you do not need to be a hotel guest to eat here. You don't even need to have a park reservation or park ticket to eat here. Anyone is welcome to come and visit. If you do drive here yourself, you get 3 hours of free parking in the Disneyland Hotel parking lot, which is not the same as the Mickey and Friends or Pixar Palace parking structures. In order to get to that parking area, you will actually drive past the entrance to the Mickey and Friends parking structure. So keep right where you would normally keep left. Continue on down the street. You will then make a right turn onto Magic Way, go past the first traffic signal, turn left at the next stop sign, and then proceed to pull a ticket and enter the parking area. Just make sure that you get your parking ticket validated either when you check in or from your server at the restaurant.
If you are headed to Goofy's Kitchen after a day in the theme parks, you will walk through downtown Disney towards the Disneyland Hotel. Just keep walking straight towards the hotel underneath the Mickey Sorcerer's hat, past the pool, and the restaurant will be right to your left as you get to the convention center area.
You do not technically need reservations to eat here. They do have limited walk-up availability, but we certainly do encourage you to have a reservation. If you're having trouble getting a reservation, keep checking. They do oftentimes pop up a day or two before, sometimes even the morning of your planned visit.
One thing to keep in mind is that if you do make a reservation and you need to make any changes or cancel that reservation, you need to do that at least 24 hours in advance of your reservation time, or there is a penalty fee that you'll have to pay.
And it's not a $10 fee like most restaurants here. They actually charge you the full adult price per person that you reserved. So you definitely don't want to get penalized that way. Breakfast runs daily from 7 to 10:30, and brunch runs from 11 to 1. The menus and pricing seem to be the same for both of those. It's $62 for adults and $34 for children. For dinner, which runs from 4 to 9 p.m., it's $75 per adult and $37 per child. They do apply Magic Key discounts, and then they do add tax and gratuity to all checks. We're gonna go ahead and check in and take a photo with Goofy decked out in his holiday attire. And the area is decorated and super cute. And Goofy's not here, but he should be here, we assume, in a minute or two. It's hard to hear, but there's actually noises that are here that sound like cooking and clanging and banging. Hi, Goof! Thank you, Goofy! Now, I don't know if you know that you got a chef back there that maybe they're an apprentice, but they're making a lot of crashing noises. Oh, it's Pluto. That makes sense. Oh, well, what you gonna do? Thank you.
Happy holidays, Goofy. Thank you.
The waiting area is filled with all sorts of Christmas decor. And here is a Goofy-looking Christmas tree. The hostess who sat us got us buttons for our group. So we have cute little Goofy's Kitchen buttons we get to wear for the holiday season. We're still waiting for our server to take our drink order before we go get food and show you what's on the buffet line. But as we're sitting here, the characters are already coming around, so here is Chip. Hi, Chip.
Hi, Chip.
How you doing?
That's your close-up.
Yeah, that's a little too close. Closer? 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 Further? Wait, I don't know what's happening now. I thought we were doing opposites. Now I don't know what's going on.
You did the hokey pokey and you turned yourself around. Want to say hi to Chip?
Jump for joy.
You dancing? You all ready for the holidays? You bought all your presents? Yeah? You ate them all?
Or are all the presents food? Or both? Both?
yeah.
Okay, that's a good plan. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, Chip.
Now I'm making my way to the buffet. Let's show you what they've got. On this part of the buffet, you pick up your plates. They got salad and all sorts of toppings for the salad. So ham, tomato, bacon, cucumber, black olives, chopped egg, beets, fire roasted corn. Over here they have sour cream, balsamic vinaigrette, ranch dressing, and croutons. They got mini bagels. There's some cream cheese for them. They have deviled eggs. They have a salad, looks like it has blackberries in it. Here is a cocktail shrimp with cocktail sauce. This says it's a beet and pear salad. This is a winter kale salad. And they have smoked salmon bellinis, though it doesn't look like the bellini is actually there, it just looks like it's smoked salmon. Here's some deli meat and cheeses. Here's toppings for, I assume, pozole or other soups. So yes, they have some pozole in there. And here is some oatmeal. And then they also have, looks like raisins and brown sugar. On the back part of the buffet here, you'll find pork sausage, bacon, breakfast potatoes, scrambled eggs, and maple glazed pork belly benedicts. That sounds really good. There's red salsa. Here's some gravy. You can get made-to-order omelets, and there's a whole bunch of different choices you can get on them, so pretty much anything you want, and egg whites are also available. Here's some sausage gravy and biscuits. Back here they have salmon beurre blanc, winter rice pilaf, duck confit chilaquiles, mashed potatoes, and a vegan hash. And here at the end they have roasted turkey and roasted sirloin, along with horseradish and cranberries and some au jus sauce. At this station back here, you will find different jams, jellies, and sauces, soy sauce included, peanut butter as well. Here's some cereals. They have Corn Flakes, Rice Krispies, Fruit Loops, and Apple Jacks. Past that, you can pick up cups or cones for soft serve ice cream. They have vanilla chocolate, or you can make a swirl. They have different toppings for them. So there's sprinkles, M&Ms, peanut butter candies, like Reese's Pieces, I guess, chocolate pearls, white pearls, and rainbow sprinkles. And here's some fresh fruit. So pineapple, watermelon, there's granola, yogurt, blueberries, blackberries, and vegan chia pudding, it says. And there's also strawberry and cantaloupe. At the middle station here, they have barbecue chicken pizza, pepperoni pizza, and cheese pizza. Here they have mac and cheese, chicken tenders, there's Mickey waffles, mozzarella sticks, French toast, and buttermilk pancakes that are shaped like Mickey, of course. And they have speculoos icing. There's also two dessert type pizzas. There's a PB&J pizza and a hazelnut s'mores pizza. You will also find maple syrup and butter here. Lastly, on the back area where all the desserts are, you will find cherry jello. There's chocolate cake. There is bread pudding, cinnamon rolls, fudge brownies, apple streusel, raspberry streusel, mini lemon bars, lemon loaf sliced up, pecan wedding cookies, chocolate chip cookies, oatmeal cookies, bran muffins, blueberry muffins, holiday frosted cupcakes, a handful of mini danishes. This says it's an almond danish. They have a fruit-filled beignet, a hazelnut-filled beignet, and they have worms and dirt, which is chocolate pudding with Oreo and gummy worms on top. If you've never been here before, every so often, every 20 to 30 minutes, the characters all come around and try and get you to wave your napkins, and they just kind of come do a little parade through the restaurant. So that's what's happening right now, so let's take a look. Jenny and I just picked up our first round of food. For the most part, what you see is what you get. So we tried to focus on the things that were unique to either this holiday meal or just unique to Goofy's Kitchen in general. So let's show you what we got. Here is my plate. So I got the duck confit chilaquiles. I got the roasted sirloin and turkey with some horseradish. I got the deviled egg. I got some cocktail shrimp with cocktail sauce. And I got the eggs benedict, which said it was pork belly, but I don't see any pork belly on there. It looks like a non-meat benedict, but we'll take a look at it and give it a try. And also I got a strip of bacon.
I am trying the special holiday pear salad, as well as a special cheese that they have here for the holidays. It might be cranberry, I'm not sure. French toast, a deviled egg, some potato hash, scrambled eggs. I'm also gonna try this eggs benedict as it doesn't look like it has meat in it. And special this year for this holiday brunch, there are Mickey waffles, pancakes, and more to dip into this speculoos icing, so cookie butter icing. So I'm really excited to try that out. So we've got some of the Mickey waffle. Let's try it with this cookie butter icing. That is really delicious. So if you like cookie butter, which is the speculoos cookies or Biscoff cookies, this is something you should definitely try. Really good.
I'm gonna give these duck confit chilaquiles a try first. They're a little messy and difficult to eat. Let's see, here we go. That's really good. It's got a nice flavor. The duck is well roasted and just nice and savory. A little bit of sour cream on there kind of balances everything out. And the chips are just the right amount of crispy. That's really good. I'm gonna give a try now to this Eggs Benedict. We don't think there's any meat in it. We think there's supposed to be, but either they ran out or they forgot or they changed it. We're not sure, but here you can see what that looks like. As far as Eggs Benedict goes, it's very good. But yeah, it doesn't have the pork belly or anything on it, so it'd be nice if we got to try that. If they put that out later or we see it looking different later, we'll give that a try.
Now Dale is coming around to our table.
Hi, Dale. I just dropped my knife as he came over.
It's okay. We're going to be okay. You want to say hi?
My day.
Bye, thanks Dale. I just tried both the turkey and the roasted sirloin, and both are really, really good. Standout dishes that I would strongly recommend here. The cocktail shrimp was also really, really good, and the deviled egg was just okay.
One thing to know about Goofy's Kitchen is that they do offer special seasonal salads, and they are really good. They're one of my favorite things every time we come here. This one has these pieces of granola that are cinnamon flavored. It has some fresh apple and some red onion and goat cheese, and it's really delicious. So definitely check out the salads if you are a salad fan.
Here comes Minnie. Hi, Minnie.
Hi, Minnie. How are you? All right. You ready for the holidays, Minnie? Yes? Everything's wrapped? Uh-huh. And you're ready to eat?
Everybody's eating for the holidays.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
I just went and got a second round, and this time the Eggs Benedict does have that pork belly underneath it, so I'm going to give that a try and let you know how it is. That's really good. Yeah, definitely much better with the pork belly on it. This is also one of the highlights of the meal so far. Chip is coming back around, so we're going to say hi to him again.
We're ready. Yeah. We're going to capture all the memories.
Love the energy. Love the energy.
He's making his own music video. Okay. Okay.
All right.
We're ready. Whoa, all right. Nice.
Nice.
Whoa.
I want
to get the energy. Yay. You got to hit the pose at the end. Thank you.
And now Dale's coming back around. I don't know if you know this, but when we're done with dessert, we can get more dessert.
We'll just keep going.
We were told until 1:30.
Fill up our cheeks? Okay. That's what we'll look like when we're done. Okay. That's a good plan.
They may not have enough out there for all of us. Well, especially not if you're going to be eating dessert too.
We are all done at Goofy's Kitchen enjoying our delicious holiday brunch.
Everything that we tried was really good. We love Goofy's Kitchen. If you haven't seen our other videos, we'll put them in the description down below, but we visited during Halloween time. We've also visited for brunch and dinner time during regular times when there's no special events going on, and it's always a good meal.
We think that Goofy's Kitchen is the best option here for character dining because it offers a large buffet with a lot of different choices, and there's definitely going to be something for everyone to eat in your group, including anyone who has any sort of allergies or food sensitivities.
We did have all four of the roaming characters visit our table, but Pluto visited while we were out getting our food the first time around, so we didn't actually get a real quality interaction with him. We could have made that happen if we waited around or asked one of the friendly cast members around to get him to come back, but we were content with what we had done and who we had met with, so we decided to not stick around longer to meet him up close and personal.
So if you are looking to have a very large, all-you-can-eat meal and meet some characters at the same time, Goofy's Kitchen is a great option.
We hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, please give us a big thumbs up. We really appreciate it.
Be sure to subscribe for even more magical content from the Disneyland Resort.
And we hope we put you in a magical mood.